It's Uncle Jimmy once again with Jimmy's Train Station and Travel Adventures, and I'm bringing a new October blog to you, another Halloween special. And that is, if you can look at my shirt, it is Casual Friday. And I brought you to the town of Hope, New Jersey, where I'm filming Friday the 13th filming scenes for the movie Friday the 13th. And I'm going to show you around and show you a few filming sites real quick. Right here, this store right here was the scene in the movie, the restaurant scene where the girl that was going to Camp Blood, she got her ride from here. This used to be a restaurant in 1979 when they filmed here, where she got her ride to Camp Blood. And I'm gonna go in and check the store out. It's an antique store now. So this is our first stop on our Friday the 13th movie filming scenes. So follow me as we continue this journey on this blog of Friday the 13th. So the lady in the shop here, she's real familiar with the movie, and she told me this is the shop which was a restaurant at the time when they filmed Friday the 13th. And I bought me a couple souvenirs here. I bought me a Camp Blood sign. It was only $8, and I got a picture for $2 here of the scene in here of Friday the 13th. Now if we walk over here, I'll show you what I'm talking about. Over here on the right, the bar was probably where they were sitting here. It was probably about in this area. But if you notice up here in the window, you see that building across the street. Right through this window here, you can see that exact building over there. So this is the restaurant, the opening scene when the girl's hitching a ride to Camp Blood. And follow me and we'll continue. There's a couple more spots here in Hope, New Jersey that I want to show you that was in the movie in the opening scenes. And then we'll head over to Blairstown, New Jersey, which is not far from here, for another scene of the movie. And then tomorrow we'll continue on. I'm actually going to Camp Blood, the real campsite, which is a Boy Scout camp here in New Jersey. And they will show you around the filming sites there. And the actual first Jason, the boy of the lake, is going to be there. And also Adrian King, who was the female in the canoe, the female that killed, the actress that killed Jason's mom in the first Friday the 13th. So follow me as we continue this adventure. Okay, here we are at another scene of Friday the 13th. This is where we meet Crazy Ralph. Now Crazy Ralph, he's the one that warns him about Camp Blood, about the girl going to Camp Blood. He's like, "Going to Camp Blood, aren't you? The place has got a death curse." And the guy she rides, I've always wanted to do that, and it's cool to do it right here. And the guy she's catching a ride with, in the scene of the movie, he puts his hand right on the corner of that post there. And Crazy Ralph actually rides his bicycle right through here and turns left down the hill and leaves the scene. Which goes right down this area. Right there's the stone bridge of that scene. And when they go around the corner, the truck that the girl gets into to ride to Camp Blood is parked right here against this building here. And nothing's really changed much since 1979 when they filmed it. The movie was released in 1980. But right there is that. So there's one more place here in Hope that I want to take you to. One of the filming sites. And that's the cemetery with the arch where he drops her off and she gets out and starts hitching a ride to Camp Blood. So follow me on this adventure as we continue on with this blog of Friday the 13th. Okay, we're at our next scene of Friday the 13th, which is just up the road, not even football field from the last location I just filmed. But this is the cemetery, and the Gothic arch here in the scene of the movie where she has dropped off after she hitches a ride on her way to Camp Blood. And she's the first victim, by the way, in the movie. If you remember, she rolls out a Jeep by this rock, which I'll show you later at Camp Blood. And Jason's mom gets her in the woods and cuts her throat against a tree. But here we are. If you watch the movie or ever watch it again, right there it is. And this is it. This is the road. So I thought I'd show you that. And we'll continue on with this Friday the 13th adventure. I hope you're enjoying this at the filming site. And follow me as we continue. Okay, folks, we're in Blairstown, New Jersey now. Another town that they film scenes from Friday the 13th. And I wanted to show you right here, this diner. This diner was in the movie. Do you remember they stopped before their way to Camp Blood? And I just wanted to show you the diner still here. It's changed a little bit since then, but it's still here. And then I'm gonna take you over and show you a couple more filming sites. So follow me as we continue this adventure. I believe we can go this way. So these are really small towns they used to film in. I'm gonna try to find some of the other filming sites. My head up this way. So follow me, and when we find the other filming sites, I'll get right back to you. So we have arrived at our other filming locations, and it's here in Blairstown, New Jersey. Pretty waterfall up here I want to show you before I show you the filming. But the filming site I wanted to show you is right here in front of us. And it's the very opening scene of the movie Friday the 13th. And it's right here. Now the bridge has changed a little bit, but the scene has the girl walking along the bridge this way. So this is another filming scene in Friday the 13th part one. Now as we walk up here around the corner, and these scenes and the Hope, New Jersey scenes were all put together to make it look like she was walking a far distance. Because the next scene shows her walking through these arches here, but as you can see, this corner right here where this real estate office is also in the scene of the movie. But the actress walks through here, through these arches. In the movie. And she actually exits in the second archway right here. Now further on down the street is another building that was in the scene of the movie. Where they have her walking down the stone archway down here. And it makes it look like she's walking a far distance. It's that blue building there up there at the end of the street that says Roy's Hall. I think it was red in the movie, and it's changed color since. But yes, right here is where it was filmed.
I'm from this town.
Lady said she's from this town, so she remembers the movie being filmed. So I wanted to show you those spots. And again, we'll continue this blog. I'll continue it tomorrow when I'm going to actually go to Camp Blood, the real filming site, and the cabins, and the beachhead where Jason's mom was killed. I had to pay a pretty good price for that. I had to pay $220, and it's a 4-hour tour. But the good thing is, like I said, Ari Lay is going to be there. Ari Lay, which was the first Jason, the boy of the lake, and Adrienne King, is she was the lady in the canoe at the end of the movie that Jason comes up out of the water and grabs. So it'll be the first time they've been together in 40 years, and I'm going to get their autographs tomorrow. So follow me as we continue on with this adventure. Before we continue the adventure tomorrow, I was just told about this place. It's a Blairstown Friday the 13th Museum. So I don't know if they're open. I'm going to go in and check it out real quick.
Oh, okay. Are you going in?
Are they open or
yes,
closed?
Yes, the ice cream is open.
The museum isn't.
Hiya.
The museum's not open.
Oh, sorry. I don't know where they're... They didn't open. We're not affiliated.
Okay. So they're closed, but I wanted to... Well, if you can peek in here, you can see Jason standing there right there. So the museum is closed today, unfortunately, or I would have... We would have stopped and visited that and seen what that was all about. Maybe we can do that some other time in the future. And over there in the corner, looks like it's Jason's mom's head. So, we'll continue tomorrow when we go to Camp Blood. So follow me on this adventure. Well, hello folks, and here we are. We are at Camp Crystal Blood. Camp Crystal Lake. We are parked outside the gate and we're waiting to get in to take our tour. The tour is from 10 to 2:30. It cost me $221 for this tour to tour the filming site of Crystal Lake Camp Blood. It's in Hardwick, New Jersey. My tour begins at 10. I have my ticket here. You have to have a ticket to get in. If you're not here at 10 with the ticket when the gate opens and you miss the opportunity to get through the gate, then you cannot go in. Like I said, it's a 4.5 hours tour. You get to tour all the cabins, all the filming sites, all the kill spots where Jason's mother killed everyone. You get to see the lake, the beachhead where Jason's mom was decapitated. There's a rock up here somewhere on your way in and out where the first victim jumped out of Jason's mom's Jeep and ran into the woods and got her throat slit. We will see that rock, but I want to show you the entrance. And there's a sign right here, Crystal Lake Tours, tickets required. And the camp is called Camp Nobisco. Camp Nobi Bosco. It's a Boy Scout camp. It's been here since the 1940s. But at the time, Hollywood wanted to use this as the filming site for the first Friday the 13th. So follow me, Uncle Jimmy, on Jimmy's Train Station and Travel Adventures as we continue this tour of Friday the 13th for our October blog, and sit back and enjoy. So I wanted to get a video here of the fireplace that began the movie where they were playing the guitar. We also get a free Crystal Lake thermos. Crystal Lake hand sanitizer, a badge. I didn't bring my glasses. Is this where you sign?
No, print your name there. Sign in the next one.
Okay. What's this here?
That is offsite emergency contact name.
And phone
number. And underneath is the phone number.
So we're taking a restroom break before we do the meet and greet and the tour. And I just wanted to show you in the distance. That's the original Camp Crystal Lake sign from the movie. The one and only. Here's a replica of the Jeep. It's Jason's mom's Jeep. And I wanted to show you the back of it because it's autographed by all the cast members that were here. Not the original, but an exact replica. And again, that's the original Camp Crystal Lake sign from the movie, the one and only.
We got the answer to our question. It's not the original.
Right, not the original.
Does that work for you? And so, do you want to use your paddles or do you want to use a machete? I can whack you.
Go ahead.
You have to go there because I'm
like this. Yeah. The integrity of the series.
So we're getting ready to get our first autograph with Alice. Adrienne King played Alice. She was the girl in the canoe at the end of the movie.
You're such a good actor. Oh, right on cue. You got it? One more. No, I want a different emotion, like, oh, I really like that.
I didn't like that one until I saw 2008.
Thank you so much.
And then that was the brother and sister story.
Oh, yeah.
And then the
brother and sister.
Will
I see you down at the beach?
Still deciding because I have a bunch of stuff to buy.
Okay. Fun time.
Hi, nice to meet you. I'm James.
Hi, James.
I got something special for you to sign. I hope it works because it's laminated.
Oh,
but
wow.
So I hope it works.
That's how, and I love a man who brings a shark.
Yeah, and you can keep that afterwards.
Oh my God, I'll give you a picture for that. Oh, this is so sweet.
Brand new. Probably should have got it ready.
He's giving you this stuff. Can you get it going?
Or you can use one of your own. That's fine. As long as it works, I don't mind.
I think I can use this one.
Okay, that'll work.
Now, do you want me to make it out to you?
Whatever you want to do.
Well, you tell me. It's your canoe.
If you can fit it on there, it's fine. It's James.
To James, and I'm going to fit it on.
Okay.
Actually, this is a better size for this.
Right.
That might have been a little too big.
That's what I was thinking.
But I'll take the pen.
Yes.
Thank you. It combines ties and teeth and tie-dye, my two favorite things. Adrian, here you go. This is ready to go.
Thank you.
I'm going to get one of these and I have.
So where'd you come from, James?
I live in Gettysburg.
How far away is that?
It's about an hour and a half to Gettysburg.
That's not bad. Nice drive on a nice day.
Right.
And is this your first time here?
Yes. And I'll see you again like in a month or two. You're going to be at another one I'm going to. I think it might
Baltimore?
Be. Baltimore? Baltimore,
yes. Yeah, I haven't been there in a decade.
It's been a long time. Yeah. What did we say? 2011. It actually is exactly a decade.
Right. I'm doing this for my kids so they'll have things to sell when they get older in my age.
Or keep.
Or keep. Yeah. Yeah, exactly.
You got to keep them. Keep the fans.
It's an investment either way, you know.
Definitely.
I was telling her there's a kid here. He's in this group.
Look,
he's
15
years old. And he loves the movies.
So cool. So cool.
See, it all works out. Let it sit before you put it back.
Well, I'll have you chop my head off.
I'm going to do it.
On video. It's filming. So.
Oh, okay. You know what? I wasn't old enough. Okay. Okay.
Oh, yeah. Wow, she was wonderful. Together.
Oh, chopping heads.
Yep, chopping heads.
Can't forget the machete.
There we go.
All right, just come this way a little bit more. You can this way a little bit more. Much better for you.
There we go.
Ready?
Just got one off my bucket list.
Yay!
Thank
you so much.
You're so welcome. I'm so happy. Anytime you can get something off that bucket list.
That's right.
It's a good thing.
We'll see you in Maryland.
Yep, see you in Maryland.
Birds. I had to prevent birds from committing suicide.
Dr. Z.
I'm like a suicide hotline for birds.
Somebody's gotta be.
Did I just say that?
You really did.
So crazy. Dr. Z.
Dr. Z.
Dr. Z. Oh, sorry. Just had to do that. Oh. Kill for mother.
There you go. That's good.
He's a doctor who kills. Don't they all? Oh, sorry. Oops. Boom. Zap!
And then, believe it or not, that was to Jason.
Jason! Another brother Jason.
He recently moved in and he introduced himself as, yeah, my name's Jason, you know, like,
okay, I thought it was gonna,
from
like,
the movie. And
like,
then he had, like, a tattoo on it.
Badass.
You totally look like a prankster.
To Jason. I never did.
I'm like,
I signed something to another Jason. If I sign Jason Never Dies and then everything's just like Jason,
yeah,
Jason.
Yeah, and I'm terrified.
I could just sign the word Jason.
Wham! And then I have one empty bottle.
Wow.
I'm fine signing it.
Look at this. It's Adrian's wine.
Yeah. I got permission to bring it because it's empty. I got permission because it was
empty. Oh, God bless you. You're smart. You actually talked to the authorities.
Yeah.
You're so where should I sign this?
We drank it last night, so we're going to have it ready for
whatever
label. I guess whatever works.
You must be feeling good today.
Sign it on the glass.
Yeah. The wines are fantastic, so I recommend them.
I'm
sure.
I'm a bad judge of everything.
Everything,
I like
everything Adrian does is fantastic. There you go. Boom.
Thank you so much.
Thank you. You guys good? Oh, do we take a picture? We do. We have to still take pictures.
Oh, got one more.
We're almost there.
Jason's moving. You ready? One, two, three.
No wonder he drank. That kid got in the wine cabinet.
All right. Thank you.
Thank you so much.
How you doing?
Welcome to Camp Crystal Lake.
Nice to meet you.
Nice to meet you today.
Can you
awesome.
Put?
I love the black mask.
Yeah,
what
cool.
can I put? Yes.
Can you put No Lives Matter?
No Lives Matter. Okay, yeah. I'll do that. do you want your name here too?
Yeah. Yeah. Name? Sure.
What's your name?
James.
James. Yeah.
Sarah, is everybody paid up?
Jason has no.
Can you give Chris your envelope?
Has no prejudices.
That's right.
No lives matter. He's an equal opportunity killer.
Yeah, you don't care.
Yeah. Step right up. Boom.
Cool. Thank Zap. You. Do you mind being videotaped? Because I asked. Huh?
No.
Okay, I'm just going to videotape this
will
real quick together.
You mean then?
It's already going?
It's already going. Okay.
Yeah. Oh my gosh. Okay, there you go.
First Rock Jason.
There we go.
Rock and roll.
Thank
All
you.
Right. Jason never died.
Nice to meet
Thank
you.
Thank
you. Hey, Ari, how you doing?
Doing great.
So that takes care of the autographs. Now we're going to do the tour of the actual camp and visit all the scenes. So follow me. I'm stoked. So was so on my bucket list. So we started the tour. We're headed down to the beach front. And if you look to the right, there's Alice's cabin from the movie. Which we'll get to go in here eventually. More photographs from the movie here.
Get out of the way.
There's the main cabin over to the right, which we'll check out later. And here we are, down on the beachfront. We're at the end of the movie. Jason's mother gets her head chopped off by Alice, which is played by Adrian King. So follow me as we continue this adventure. So this is the shower house where they filmed in the movie. That's where the girl gets the axe in the head.
In the head, yeah.
In the head.
You have a shower back here, yeah.
And a shower, muck shower. So this is the building they used for that scene. So we'll continue the adventure. Follow me.
Unless you want to keep going down the trail.
The canoe scene.
Up to you.
It's a little thicker than that.
Well, that's you.
in a moment. You can take it.
So this is the main cabin. Did most of the filming in. That's the original totem pole right there from the movie. This is where they had strict monopoly. Fireplace. There's the rope that she tied to barricade herself in, Alice, at the end of the movie. Picture from the movie. This would have been the kitchen and the pantry area. So is this the window?
That's the window.
This is the window. Yeah. What was the character's name again?
Brenda.
Brenda was thrown out of in Friday the 13th. They didn't replace that. They placed it with plexiglass, and it's the same color as the cabin would have been.
Yeah.
They used this green Hollywood did, and that's what side the inside and the outside of the cabin was. Except for this window, they just replaced it with plexiglass. Scene from this room. And we'll continue the adventure. So I'd like to point out, this is Brenda's cabin. This is the cabin Kevin Bacon gets killed in Friday the 13th. But while we're down here, we're on the beach. See the mountain, the iconic mountain in the background to let you know where it Camp Blood.
Or with Ned when the girl shows up. No, that didn't age well, even that part.
Yeah. We always like to make the joke they couldn't refilm this movie if they tried.
So we'll be going into Brenda's cabin next to see the bunks and where Kevin Bacon was killed. So follow me.
3 minutes of bacon coffee.
All right, folks, here's the rack that Ned died on the top. In the bottom were Kevin Bacon. Jack and Marcy had their thing, and where Kevin Bacon got killed. With the arrow through the throat. Marcy scene where she goes to the sink and freshen up, and this is the sink. And that would be Marcy's room. And there is the candle, the actual candle holder in the movie. I was told that they used a lot of stuff here that was already here because it was such a low budget film. They used anything they could grab from the Boy Scout camp here. So we'll continue on. Follow me.
Keep them alive not only for tours but also for scouts to use over the summer. However, on that note, there's also the idea of building up. So
cabin used
here,
to sit here
right
is
shoulder.
No here
is
not
post,
here anymore
right?
It was a trading post.
It's got air conditioned flush toilets,
one where Mr. Chrissy was being weird and creepy to Alice, but it's set right here.
Beautiful building up, a porch all the way around. Scouts go in there all year, they get their sugary treats, they get whatever.
We'll be going down to Alice's cabin soon, so follow me. Okay, we're going into Alice's cabin here. This is the cabin that Snake was killed in. In which the snake was a real rat, black snake that was killed with the machete. And the snake wrangler did not know that they were going to actually kill his snake. And he was pretty upset about it. Wouldn't be able to get away with that today. So folks, that's pretty much the tour. This is the end of this blog. And once again, it's been Uncle Jimmy with Jimmy's Train Station and Travel Adventures. I ask you please subscribe to my channel. Give it a thumbs up. Hit the notification bell up in the right hand corner to let you know when a new video is uploaded. And in the meantime, go out and have your own adventures and enjoy life. Till next time, goodbye.